Thank you, Joshua. We're here with Cesar Garcia, the program manager for Solar Orbiter. Thank you for coming over and talking to us, and congratulations.
Thank you very much. This is a very good moment.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about the moment, just a few minutes ago where you made the announcement.
Yeah, there's always a bit of tension before you get the signal, and we got the signal of the spacecraft pretty quickly, and that's a good sign. And then we had to deploy, point to the sun and deploy the solar arrays. Then there was a switchover of the login antennas, and it took a bit longer to receive the information that the solar array had fully deployed. So we were a bit tense. And then we got the confirmation, and then once you get the confirmation, then it's like, well, the water's calm, and then you start becoming not only, let's say, confident, but extremely happy. And then there's the moment when you start hugging people around, because this is the moment after so many years of work that Tim was saying before, and we are on the way to the sun. Let's go Solar Orbiter. It's a fantastic moment, and it's really something unique, if I may say.
And you may, and it was certainly capped with a lot of celebration. Saw you hugging a lot of people in the room, a lot of handshakes. And going back to the beginning of launch, where we launched right at 11:03 Eastern time from right here at the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, what was launch like for you as you kind of experienced that here inside the Mission Director Center?
Well, I have to admit that I abandoned post. Nominally, I should have stayed on post continuously throughout the launch, but after L-minus 15 seconds, where we cannot call hold anymore, so I actually picked up the phone and called our colleagues in ISOC so that I could still have permanent contact with them on the phone. Okay. And we ran out to see the launch, and it's a fantastic experience. First, you see, you know, the night is is lit by the rocket, and then like 15 seconds later you start feeling not hearing but feeling the roar, and then you see all the dreams, all the expectations going up in sky, and it was very clear sky. We could see it for very many seconds going southeast, and I don't know, it's difficult to for me to describe it, but it's like, well, we're unstoppable.
You get that feeling.
Yeah.
Right? I love that you actually got up and got on the phone so that you could stay connected.
Yes.
And got outside to see a launch, because that is one of the most amazing things about, for folks who live here who get to see these launches, but even those who travel here from long distances to watch it, it's a very unique experience.
Yeah. It is. I mean, we've been here for a few months. We've been able to see some other launches before. Mm-hmm. But nothing compares to actually seeing your spacecraft is going up. And then you see, as I said, the dreams and the expectations of so many people going up with a rocket and with the spacecraft in this case.
Right.
And it was fantastic to see it up. And then it was, of course, very interesting to follow the trajectory, also through the quiet moments during the coasting phase, and then the excitation of the end when, you know, there is the separation, and then you start getting the good signs that the separation was adequate, that the trajectory was adequate, that we acquired the signal, and then eventually that we have positive power on the spacecraft. Now the spacecraft is safe, it's pointing to the sun, and it's quite robust now to the next days, where we'll start operating the various deployables and subsystems.
Right, very good. And so you got a lot of work ahead of you, certainly, no doubt. Probably the tough part of spaceflight is over, but now a couple of years before the science starts, right?
Yeah. Well, the first few days are critical, where we do the basic deployments and the basic tests. Then during February, we will do, again, a complete checkout of all the systems, and slowly we will start switching on the instruments. We will be making sure that the instruments are operational, and that they can as well change modes of operation and so on. And we expect to finalize this phase of testing in June, end of June. However, we can, some of the instruments will start measuring immediately, but some instruments will wait a bit longer until the volatiles in the and the water will evaporate or sublimate from the spacecraft. But yeah, in 3 months, we will be able to start taking science data.
Oh, that's exciting.
It is exciting.
That early.
Yeah.
Oh, very good.
I mean, we always say, well, we want to wait for 1.8 years until the perihelion gets closer. But I think our scientists will not wait. They will start immediately to take data, and I'm sure that it will start very early to learn from the sun.
Fire up those instruments. You got it pointed at the sun.
Absolutely.
Let's start getting some data, right?
Absolutely.
Well, you're going to leave here certainly a changed person, right? Because I believe that you've got some kind of tattoo.
Oh, yeah.
You want to show that to
me? Yeah, I can show this.
Yeah, that's a solar orbiter temporary tattoo.
It's a painless. It's a painless tattoo, and I think I will wear it with pride.
Oh, very good. Don't wash it off for a long time.
Well, I might have to take a shower one of these days.
Well, certainly your spacecraft's going to leave quite the imprint on our scientific community. We're very excited to get that data back and learn a lot more about this star that keeps us alive.
Yeah, I think this is the purpose of this mission, is the purpose of other missions before us, and then of missions that will come. It's the purpose of ground instrumentation, which is also investigating the sun. And I think it's a growing community. Space weather is coming very strong. We will need to understand our star much better so that we can support our infrastructure, but also our astronauts as they go deeper into the solar system. So this is a growing field.
Absolutely. Cesar Garcia, Program Manager for Solar Orbiter. Thank you very much for your time.
It's a pleasure being with you tonight.
It's good to see you again.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.